I would say it was 1999 or maybe 1998, and as fate would have it, not a buck short or a moment too late. A mother and her child sat side by side with the sun still on their side, and a moment of silence was all it took for a voice to echo from the front of the bus to the insides of their ears and hearts.
The seat right there, next to the niche.
Do I have your attention? Or am I just stoking the fire? Pointing fingers and bridges burning while fingers point at burning bridges on which we all stand.
Go back to where you came from!
Where? Right here?
Tag, you're it.
Tick-tock. We're losing time, but I'll follow you if you follow me.
Do I have your attention? Imagine a camera panning over every face, every race, dreams,
fears,
hope, suffering, pain.
Are we not all the same?
So why are we so divided? We can be one. If you choose to see it from both sides. And I've finally realized through these real eyes that these lines drawn in the sand only stand to divide us. And what was always meant to be together.
Like my mother always said, do I have your attention?
Oh, silent night. Come as you are. And let us not forget that on this night,
everyone sits at the same table. Everyone's at the same table. Do I have your attention?
Are we not all born with a gift? Called a voice to use, to speak up, to stand up, to stand up! Speak! Wake up!
Do I have your attention?
What side makes this right? Does your left hand hate the right?
What face do I have to put on for you to ease up?
Your daughters, your sons, your husbands, your wives, yours? Do I have your attention? Let's play a game. Truth or dare?
I dare you to face the truth.
For our sake, let the ground beneath your feet shake. Let your weary hearts open up. There's too much at stake here.
Do I have your attention?
Could you learn to see me? What if I learned to see you?
Because I do see.
You have my attention.
It's not so black and white.
Or maybe it is.